Hello everybody, welcome to this class on stress management. Well, this is a very important topic. I really feel stress affect all of us. You might be belonging to any age group, living in any part of the city, world or the country, might be coming from different background or culture. Well, stress is a part of our life. We need to accept this part. Today in this video, we talk about stress management. Let's get started. Well, the content today is going to understand what stress all about, introductory part, meaning, definitions, source of stress, sources of occupational stress. Let's start with introductory part. Stress is an individual response to a disturbing factor in the environment and the consequences of such action. Stress is a part of life. Everyone feels stress at one time or another. The experience of stress and the way one responds to it are unique to each individual. The process of responding to stress is constant and dynamic and is essential to the person's physical, emotional, and social well-being. Stress is defined in terms of how it impacts physical and psychological health. It includes mental, physical, and emotional strain. Stress occurs when a demand exceeds an individual coping ability and disrupts his or her psychological equilibrium. Stress occurs in the workplace when an individual employee perceives a situation to be too stressful to handle and therefore threatening to his or her well-being. Well, stress is an individual response to a disturbing factor in the environment and the consequences of such reaction. Stress refers to response to the event that threaten or challenge a person. So it is an event that will be threatening an individual person. So next is meaning of work stress. Work stress refers to the harmful physical and emotional responses that people experience on their jobs. So, in workplace, what are the challenges, what are the pressures they are facing? That response will be called as work stress. And the next meaning is stresses. The physical and psychological demands from the environment that cause stress are called stresses. Here, the event that threatens or challenges a person, that will be called as stresses. If I have to give definition of stress, what exactly is stress? According to ILO, it is recognized worldwide as a major challenge to individual mental and physical health and organizational health. And second definition is according to Searle, 1956, stress is defined as pressure experienced by a person in response to life demands. These demands are referred to as stresses and include a range of life events, physical factors like cold, hunger, hemorrhage and pain, environmental condition and personal thoughts. Let's understand what are the sources of stress here. Same situation, two people, one might get affected, one might not get affected by stress. So there are many sources of stress. These are broadly classified as internal stresses, external stresses, development stresses, situational stresses. First one, internal stresses. They originate within a person. Example, cancer, feeling of depression. If you are taking example of health issues, so it will originate within a person. The stressor is originated within a person because of health issue. The pressure will be because of he is suffering from some health issue. So that's why it is called as internal stresses. And second one is external stresses. It originates outside the individual, not within a person. Example, moving to another city, death in a family. So if you are taking example of moving to another city, so one person moving from one city to another city because of job or any other example. So at that time he is facing several problems. There may be changes in environment, people and workplace, everything will be changed. So because of that, he will face several stress or several pressure from that events. And third one is development stresses. It occurs at predictable time throughout an individual life. Example, child beginning of school. And the fourth one is situational stresses. They are unpredictable and occur at any time during life. So if you are going for third point, development stresses, it is predictable one and it occurs throughout an individual life. But in case of situational stresses, it is occur at any time during a life and unpredictable one. It may be positive or in a negative way. Example, death of a family member, marriage, divorce, etc. So, this is about sources of stress in general sense. Let's understand what are the sources of occupational stress. Stresses originate at individual, group, organizational and extra organizational levels. So, in that first one, individual level stresses. These relates directly to a person, personality and job responsibilities. The most common individual level stresses are type of personality, role overload, role conflict, role ambiguity. In that, type of personality. In respect of personality, two concepts. That is, type A personality and type B personality are relevant in this context, right? Type A personality facing high stress rather than type B personality, because the nature of type A personality is always moves, walks and eats rapidly. They feel impatient with the pace of things, hurries others, dislikes waiting, feels guilty when relaxing, does several things simultaneously, tries to schedule more and more in less and less time, does not have time to enjoy life. So comparing to type B personality, type A personality facing stress because the achievement orientation, impatience and perfectionism of individuals with type A personality may create stress in work circumstances that other person find relatively stress-free. And about role overload. Too much of work causes stress to an employee. So this is also one of the individual level stresses. So because of overload and of underload of workload, they're facing this level of stress. And the next is a role conflict. A role conflict occurs when people face competing demands. There are two types of role conflicts in organizations, interrole and personal. Interrole conflicts occurs when an employee has two roles that are in conflict with each other. Interrole conflict is common in matrix organization where subordinates will be shared by matrix bosses. And in case of personal conflict, it occurs when personal values clashes with organization goals. So interrole conflicts is occurs because of two roles they are facing or two roles they are doing. And in case of personal conflict, the personal values is clashes with organizational goals. That's why the stress will occurs. And next, role ambiguity in individual level stresses. It exists when employees are uncertain about their responsibilities, functions, performance expectations, and level of authority. So this tends to occur when people enter into new situations such as joining the organization or taking foreign assignments because they are uncertain about task and social expectations. So this is about individual level stresses. Next one is organizational stresses. It affects large number of employees. It includes organization climate, management styles, organizational design, life cycle, etc. If I am taking organization climate here, poor lighting, loud noise, improper placement of furniture and dirty and smelly environment create stress. Managers should monitor these and eliminate them at the earliest because it's also reason for stress. If I am taking the another example is organizational design or structure, which is also a reason for organizational stresses. Organizational structure defines the level of differentiation, the degree of rules and regulations, and where decisions are made. So excessive rules and lack of participation in decision that affects an employee, and it also causes stress. And about organization life cycle. Life cycle, organization like human beings passes through our life cycle. The life cycle of an organization comprises 8 stages: birth, growth, policy, procedure, theory, religion, ritual, last rites. So in this cycle, the organization is born and then has its growth. So policies are developed to guide decisions, and these are carried out through procedures. So because of all these procedures and all, they are facing pressurized environment. So this is about organizational stresses. Next source of occupational stress is group level stresses. Group level stresses are caused by group dynamics and managerial behaviors. It includes managerial behavior, lack of cohesiveness, intergroup conflict, status incongruence, sexual harassment, workplace violence. In that, first, managerial behavior. If I am taking managerial behavior, managers create stress for employees by exhibiting inconsistent behaviors, failing to provide support, showing lack of concern, providing inadequate direction, creating a high productivity environment, focusing on negative while ignoring good performance. So because of all these things, because of managers' behavior, it will cause stress in employees. And about another serious intrapersonal stressor is rising the wave of physical violence and aggression in the workplace. It is estimated that more than 1,000 employees are murdered at work each year in the US. Workplace violence include assaults, rape and threats using of weapons. And the next sources of occupational stress is extra organizational stresses. These are caused by factors outside the organization. For instance, conflicts associated with one's career and family life are stressful. It includes family, economy, lack of mobility, quality of life. If I am taking home life, certainly impacts one's attitude and performance at work. Another example is death of spouse, injury to one's child, failure in school or at work, and similar other life events can be stressful. So these are about occupational stresses which was faced by employees at organization. This chart shows about sources of stress which I already discussed. By this, I will end up first part of stress management. Thank you.